Hello, welcome to the lecture number 6 of the course Quantum Mechanics and Molecular Spectroscopy. We will have a quick recap of contents of lecture number 5. In the lecture number 5, we looked at the perturbation theory of two states, in which if we had a Hamiltonian H naught such that it acted on state 1 and produced E11 and H naught acting on state 2 gives you E22, and the states 1 and 2 form complete set, and they are orthonormal. Orthonormal simply means integral of 1 over 2 is equal to 0 and integral of 1 over 1 should be equal to 2 over 2, this is equal to 1. Okay? Now, we said that there is a time dependent perturbation that acts on states 1 and 2 or this system, which is nothing but H prime of t, and this when added to H naught will give you the total Hamiltonian H, and it will follow the time dependent Schrodinger equation . Okay. In this case, the psi is a superposition state one can think of. Psi is equal to A1 of t e to the power of minus I E1 t by H bar 1 plus A2 of t e to the power of minus I E2 t by H bar 2. Okay. So, this is the wave function psi. Now, by plugging the psi in the Schrodinger equation, we ended up with following equation after doing some amount of algebra. That is nothing but I H bar A1 dot t e to the power of minus I E1 t by H bar should be equal to A2 of t e to the power of minus I e to the power of minus I minus E2 t by H bar integral over 1 H prime of t 2. Similarly, we had I H bar A2 dot t e to the power of minus I E2 t by H bar is equal to A1 of t e to the power of minus E1 t by H bar 2 H prime of t 1. Okay? So, these are the equations that we ended up in the last lecture. Now, let us start looking at this equation little bit more carefully. I H bar A1 dot t e to the power of minus I E1 t by H bar equals to A2 t e to the power of minus I E2 t by H bar 1 H prime of t Okay. Now, of course, this is an definite integral. This definite integral will give you some number. Okay. It could be 0, but definitely it could be a number. If this is some number and a to t is a coefficient and e to the power of minus I, this is the phase factor. So, all this tells you that the time dependence of a, by the way, a1 dot t is nothing but t by dt of a1 of t. So, the time dependence of a1 coefficient will depend on the a2 coefficient. Okay. One can rewrite this little bit in a different way. So, a1 dot t is equal to, so one can take ih bar on the other side, ih bar into a2 of t e to the power of, now you can take this exponential function on the other side. So, what you will get is minus I e2 minus e1 into t by h bar and the integral 1 h prime of t 2. Okay. Now, of course, if you can write e2 minus e1 is equal to delta e 2 1. So, this is equal to h bar omega 2 1. So, if I write that way, then I get a1 dot t is equal to 1 over I h bar a2 of t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t, because this h bar and that h bar will get cancelled, okay, into 1 h prime t. Okay. Now, you can also rewrite this same equation starting from the other equation for a2 dot. So, that will come out to be a2 dot of t will be equal to 1 over I h bar a1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t 2 prime of t 1. Now, we will quickly realize if h prime of t is Hermitian, then the integrals 1 h prime t 2 should be equal to 2 h prime t 1. Of course, this is only true when if h prime t is Hermitian, then you will see that this one and this two will be equal, or if they are not even, if this h is not Hermitian, then this will be complex conjugates of each other. Now, you will see that this is, if you look at the constants, this is I h bar is a constant. Okay. Now, these are some constants because they are definite integrals. Okay. We'll have either complex conjugate of each other or they are equal to each other. Now, all you can see that a1 dot's dependence on a2 is with this function e to the power of minus I omega 2 1, while as a2 dot's dependence will be on e to the power of I omega 2 1. So, these two functions are out of phase with respect to each other. It is simply something like this. Okay. So, that will be our a2. So, whenever a2 will go up, a1 will come down, and whenever a2 will come down, a1 will go up. Okay. So, that is the time dependence of the a1 and a2, which are out of phase. A1 of t and a2 of t are out of phase with respect to each other. Okay. Now, if such is the scenario, so we need to solve this coupled differential equations, which are nothing but dA1 of t by dt is equal to A1 A2 of t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t 1 h prime t 2 and dA2 t by dt equals to whole thing divided by 1 h power A1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t 2 h prime of t. Okay, so these two are coupled differential equation. Okay, and such that A1 of t and A2 of t are out of phase with respect to each other. Okay. Now, of course, it's kind of difficult to solve, but we'll make an attempt. Now, let us assume there are two states, 1 and 2. With energies E1 and E2. Okay. Now, at time t is equal to 0, I am going to switch on a constant, a perturbation. Okay. And it is constant. So, what happens is that at time net double, if I think of perturbation, so I will switch on at time t is equal to 0, this is time. Is equal to 0, I will switch on a constant perturbation for some time, okay, until this goes to say t prime, okay, and I will have some value, let us me call it as v, okay. So, this is v, okay. Now, in a such a way that this one h prime of t 2 becomes h prime h bar v and 2 h prime of t 1 becomes h bar v star. Okay, so where v and v star are complex conjugates with respect to each other. In fact, if you look at these integrals, these integrals are complex conjugates of each other. So, if such is the scenario, then your A1 dot t will be equal to 1 over I h bar A2 of t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t and we had this integral 1 h I am 2 h bar t 2, okay, and other integral was a 2 dot t is equal to 1 by I h bar a 1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t 2 h bar h prime t, okay, 1. Now, this integral of course is equal to h bar v and this integral equals to h bar v star. Okay. Then what happens? I can rewrite these equations as the following. A1 dot t is equal to this h bar and this h bar will cancel. I in the numerator will go to, in the denominator will go to numerator as minus I. So, minus I v A2 e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t that will be A1 dot and your A2 dot t will be equal to minus I V star A1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t. Okay. So, I am going to rewrite them again. So, what you had is A1 dot t equals to minus I V A2 of t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t. Okay. And A2 dot t is equal to minus I V star A2 of A1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t. So, what I am going to do is I am going to rewrite this equation in a slightly different way. So, what I will do is this, I'll write in terms of A1 and A2. So, one can rewrite this equation as this will become A2 equals to minus 1 by IV A1 dot t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t. Because if this I take on the other side, minus I omega 2 1 will become plus. And this will become A1 of t, it also is of t, will become minus 1 by I V star A2 dot t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t. Okay. Now, what I will do is I will differentiate once more. Differentiate both the equations with respect to time. Okay. So, what I will get is if I differentiate once more and rearrange, okay, what I will get is the following: A1 double dot t equals to minus IV A2 dot t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t minus omega 2 1 V A2 of t e to the power of minus I omega 2 1 t. Okay. Similarly, I can get A2 dot t equals to minus I V star A1 dot t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t plus omega 2 1 to V star A1 of t e to the power of I omega 2 1 t. Okay. Then what I can do is instead of A1 and A2 I can plug these here, and finally what I can get is the following after rearrangement. What I get is A1 double dot t equals to minus A1 of t V V star minus I omega 2 1 A1 dot t. Similarly, A2 dot t is equal to minus A2 of t V V star plus I omega 2 1 A 2 dot t. So, one can do, you know, you can all use this, you know, four equations, okay, and rearrange, okay, because wherever there is a A1 dot, you can plug it in wherever there is an A1, you can plug it in A2 dot, and then you can do amount of rearrangement. It's not very easy, one can do it as a homework. So this is conversion of these to this. Okay, you can try it as a homework. It's not very easy, it takes little more than 10 or 15 minutes. Or this is just simple math, so one can be able to do it. So what we have is these two equations. Okay, so the two equations that we have is very simply that A1 double dot T is equal to minus A1 of T V star minus omega 21 minus I omega 21 A1 dot of T and A2 double dot of T is equal to minus A2 of T V star plus I omega 21 of A2 dot T. Now, by writing this, we have done one thing very simple. Now, the equation 1 will only consist of A1 of T. A1 of T, its first derivative and its second derivative. And this equation 2 will have only A2 of T. So, A2, its first derivative and its second derivative with respect to. So, what we have done by doing this, we have separated out the coupled differential equations in A1 and A2 as second order differential equations in A1 and A2 respectively. So, they are no longer coupled. Okay? But by from going from first order equations to, we went to second order equation, differential equations to uncouple them. Now, if you have such a case, one can find a general solution. A1 of t will be equal to a e to the power of I omega t minus b e to the power of minus I omega t e to the power of omega 21 t by 2 and a2 of t is equal to a e to the power of I omega t plus b e to the power of minus I omega t e to the power of omega 21 t by 2 and where omega will be equal to half of omega 21 square plus 4 times modulus of v square whole to the power of half. And a and b are constants which will depend on initial conditions. Okay? Now, one can solve this with the condition that at t is equal to 0, a1 of 0 is equal to 1 and a2 of 0 is equal to 0. Why are we doing that? Because if we had two states 1 and 2 and their coefficients being a1 of t and a2 of t, at time t is equal to 0, we are assuming that the population is only in the state 1 and state 2 has no population. And when you do that, these equations will go down to a1 of t will be equal to cos omega t plus I omega 21 by 2 omega sin omega t whole thing I e to the power of minus I omega 21 t by 2. and A2 of t will be equal to minus I by modulus of V by omega sine e to the power of I omega 2 1 t by 2. So, these are the two equations that end up. And one can then equate the probability, get the probability. So, P1 of t will be nothing but modulus of A1 of t whole square, and P2 of t, that is probability of finding the state, the system in state 2, is A2 of t modulus square. Okay. In such scenario, what we will get is the following. Okay. P1 of t, after doing some math, what we will get is 1 minus 4 modulus of V square divided by omega 2 1 square plus 4 times modulus of V square into sine square half of omega 2 1 square plus 4 times modulus of V whole square to the power of half, and P2 of t will be equal to modulus of V by omega square sine omega t, which will be nothing but 4 times modulus of V square divided by omega 2 1 square plus 4 times modulus of V whole square sine square half of omega 2 1 square plus 4 times modulus of V square to the power of half. Now, one can think of it, this is P2 of t. Now, think of it like this. So, there is some function that is sine square x and some multiplier. Now, let us look at P2. P2 of t, no, this is sine square of some function, okay, multiplied by something. So, let us call it as A sine square x. Okay. So, P1 of t is nothing but 1 minus A sine square of x. So, at time t is equal to 0, let us say this is 0 and this is 1, that is the population. Now, if I take population, then my A1 will go up, go down like that. So, this is P1 of t, and A2 will whenever will go like this. So, this is P2 of t, such that P1 of t plus P2 of t is equal to 1. These oscillations of states 1 and 2 are called Rabi oscillations. Okay. So, we will stop here and continue in the next lecture. Thank you.